How Growing Up Changed My Opinion on Benson by McBean.
That's true. That's true. You get different perspectives when you like when you were growing up. Like Benson, he was just trying to be a good manager, and you know, they was goofing off, but it's, I don't know. Maybe because I'm still like, I got a job, but I'm not the manager. I'm still a worker. I'm Mordecai and Rigby. So I'm like, you know what I'm saying? I'm just trying to have fun. Come on, man, stop playing. But I don't think they did any work. It does change your perspective. Like, when you're younger, you see Benson like, yo, what are you doing right now? You trying to mess up their fun. Like, let them do donuts in the pit. Like, come on, man. You messing up the vibe right now. I'm just trying to have fun. Now it's like he's mad patient. The fact that he's not doing more than just yelling is crazy. It's crazy.
I'm currently in the middle of rewatching the entirety of Regular Show for the fifth time because that's how good this show is.
It's crazy.
And with this being my
crazy
second full year as a legal adult and my fourth as a legal working member of society, I start
16.
To find myself understanding and being more sympathetic to the characters that are often seen as buzzkills or jerks. One of those characters being Benson.
Benson
is the manager.
Main characters that get that nickname. He has to be. That was his shtick. That was literally his shtick, except maybe certain episodes where he was the focus, but that was, you know.
One of those characters being Benson. Benson is the manager at the park and is in charge of everyone who works there. He gets along smoothly with pretty much all of his employees, except
pops,
Mordecai and Rigby. If you've watched the show, you can obviously see why. They're two 23-year-old slackers,
how you know,
and
93%
of anything they touch or try to do just ends up being a disaster. But as a kid, I didn't see it like this.
Wall.
To me, Mordecai and Rigby were just two guys trying to chill, mess around, and have fun. But old man Benson would just come out of nowhere and kill the mood.
Benson.
One episode that I don't remember my reaction to as a kid, but when I rewatched it now, shit hit me hard. That episode was season 3, episode 26, Busted Cart. The episode starts off with Mordecai and Rigby doing some dangerous stunt course on the cart. Obviously, this ends in disaster.
Of course. They broke the cart? Nah, I don't remember that.
Sees this and holds him responsible for Mordecai and Rigby's destructive behavior.
Oh, wow.
But the dealership's too far away. I'll have to drive all day and night.
Sounds like a personal problem.
I actually do remember this.
Get that cart fixed or you're fired!
Already, I'm starting to feel bad for poor
Benson.
Because I know nobody likes to be blamed or held responsible for some shit they had nothing to do with.
True.
I remember this happening to me when I worked in a frozen yogurt store. I was the newest and the youngest employee, which left me to get blamed for shit like turning the machines off and making the yogurt go bad. Even though I barely went near the machines when I started and had no idea how they worked. But anyway, now Benson has to drive over 1,000 miles all day and all night to make it
man,
to the
dealership.
And to his surprise, he is joined by none other than Mordecai and Rigby, who defied his orders not to go with him.
Does the word not process into your thick skulls?
Of course not. Wait,
having already driven too far to turn back, he brings them along anyway. They start to bond and even share a dance number to electro pop music. They are making good time heading to the dealership until Mordecai starts to notice Benson getting sleepy and insists
on taking
over.
Yeah, he messed up something.
Benson agrees and asks them to wake him up in 2 hours. Things are continuing to go well until they notice a sign for an arcade nearby and swear they're only going to play for 30 minutes.
And they beat it
till this morning. I don't know about you guys, but every single time I say I'm going to do something for 30 minutes, it turns into multiple hours.
You gotta be
I don't
a timer.
Think anyone
you gotta
on this
a timer
plan
on your stuff,
realistically does anything fun for just 30 minutes. But as you'd imagine, this too ends in disaster. Mordecai and Rigby play all night, forget to wake Benson up, which results in him sleeping all night and waking up in the arcade parking lot the next morning. He finds them, drags them outside, and delivers one of the most heartbreaking meltdowns in TV history.
Fired.
There for hours. Now we're never gonna make it to the dealership in time. It closes in 30 minutes.
We're sorry. We didn't know it was daytime. There aren't any windows in the arcade.
Excuses! Excuses! How am I supposed to trust you when all you give me are excuses? Mm. When are you two gonna learn that your actions have consequences? Consequences that affect other people, like me. Don't you two understand? I'm about to lose my job. You may not care about keeping your jobs, but I care about keeping mine. Because if I lose my job, I have nothing. Do you hear me? I have nothing. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to take my last bathroom break as an employed man.
This. Dang. Come on, midway. I want to laugh.
Rewatching this scene.
Where he said it. Come on, it is powerful. Now that's very serious, especially if you're thinking in real perspective, but dang, when he started whining.
My last bathroom break as an employed man.
Mm. This.
But that's real though. That's real though. But right like here.
Rewatching this scene left me with the same facial expression as Mordecai and Rigby.
Oh, for real?
This really put into perspective.
I didn't act my age, man. I think this man said he was like, what, 20? 21, man. I need to act my age, bro. I'm laughing. Come on, man. I'm doing the same thing I was doing when I was like 12.
What he was going through. I bet for most of you in like elementary school.
It's a weird noise he made. Come on, man.
Show, you're probably thinking, what's the big deal? Just get another job. But maturing is realizing how hard Benson works to keep things in order.
I know the pain. But
and
it's still
how
like
determined
funny to me.
He was to drive over 1,000 miles on 0 hours of sleep to fix a golf cart that he didn't even wreck. On top of that, his job is now on the line because of someone else. At this point, you have to feel for him. The episode finishes off with them taking the most dangerous road in the country, surviving with extreme karting and getting to the dealership just in time before it closes. To sort of put everything together, though, I think the beautiful thing about characters in shows like this is that as time goes on, you start to relate to the characters that were often seen as wet blankets.
Doing 360s on them. Stop playing.
Sort of thing. When you you were able to relate and click with characters
one parking
like
spot.
Mordecai and Rigby, Gumball and Darwin, SpongeBob and Patrick, etc.
Sounds like a grown
the
man.
Young, dumb, immature protagonist.
I want to be SpongeBob. What are you talking about? I want to be Squidward? SpongeBob and Squidward are two different sides of like grown men. SpongeBob's a grown man, but he just focused on his tasks. He's in a moment. He's in a moment. Squidward is a failed artist. He has pain behind him.
Able to understand their perspective of whatever situation, because up until then, being young, dumb, and immature is all we knew. Now having become somewhat of an adult and getting a taste of real world responsibility, as can many of you, can start seeing and understanding whatever situation from the perspective of the characters that aren't the protagonist. Like Nicole from The Amazing World of Gumball, like Squidward from SpongeBob, and of course, like Benson from Regular Show. This doesn't mean that Benson was just this great boss and deserved this mountain of praise for his efforts. He was definitely overboard with his temper.
True, especially in the smallest moments.
And at times,
he got
snubbed. Kind of
wait,
with
what was that part?
Overboard with his temper, and sometimes a bit insensitive. And at times, got kind of abusive with his power over his employees. But besides those things, Benson had his moments outside of his boss persona, hanging out, having fun, and actually being a down-to-earth
cool drunk off the
guy.
Spice.
And so far, watching the series, Benson is probably my favorite character. After it being Mordecai for my entire youth,
I hope others, like myself, while rewatching the show,
start to realize that Benson wasn't just some asshole trying to take a piss on everyone's parade. He was just trying to do his job the best he could.
You think your little pranks are funny, huh? You think they're funny? Well, what do you guys think of my prank? Ring, ring. Hello, what's that? Mordecai and Rigby are banned from using the house phone? Okay. Good luck making your prank calls now!
Yes, one of the greatest moments in Regular Show. Facts. That's a fact. That's a fact, bro.
I think he missed, like,
little something in it. Like, he was like, this is all I have. Like, a lot of adults, the job is all they have. The job is like, their job is them. Cause the job requires a lot of you. So you put a lot of you in it, you know? If he got fired from it, I think he did. Did he get fired from the job or something like that? I remember him being depressed in like one episode. I don't know if he got fired or something like that. But he was like mad sad. But yeah, if they missing their job, they're going to be looking like Benson right there, crying with their hand. They're going to be looking like that, yeah?